last time out at Silverstone. The race was action-packed. However, for the CRS Ferrari team, it proved a bit more difficult than it needed to be. A misunderstanding of the rules saw them leave the car doors open during the refueling in the pit stop. The officials took a dim view of this and awarded a 10-second stop-go penalty, a mistake that could have cost them the victory.
Could have cost us, could have sent me for a year in exile in A1 Grand Prix if James hadn't come through and won the race. It was an error on my part. I'm team manager, I take responsibility for it. We've had a very full programme this year with 10 FIA races and 8 British GT races. We'd come back from an FIA race, I was still in FIA mode where the door can be open, and got it wrong, simple.
For Malcolm though, he has the added pressure of dealing with the drivers who are all fighting for the runners-up spot in the championship.
It's just a complete nightmare. The Irish are the worst wind-up merchants you'll ever come across, and they're both old enough to be the rest of the guy's father. It just goes on and on and on. And then you have the silent types like Michael Meadows who are just plotting all the time. James Sutton, who's just ram full of confidence and doesn't think about anybody else. And you never know quite what you've got with Luke. And to be perfectly honest, if anybody wants my job, they can have it this weekend.
At Silverstone.
There's a replay of the marshals just dealing with the fire. It wasn't a major thing, it was all external, so it's obviously a lot worse when it's inside the car, more difficult to get to. So the safety car starting to wave through those guys. They will all gain time on the leader there, the red Ferrari of Luke Hines. And Hines needs to stop.
Oh dear. And he's forgotten he's the leader. Oh dear, oh dear.
Yeah, so let's see if Godfrey Jones, who is in second place, let's see if he knows the rules. And he does indeed stay behind the safety car.
Into the pits come some of the more...
Yeah.
That was Michael Meadows coming to a quick halt. And James Sutton will take over from him. So the leader, theoretically, should still be the car that Luke Hines started with Jeremy Metcalfe on board, car number 16. So we'll have to wait and see exactly where that ends up in the queue.
So the CR Scuderia team, they keep the doors closed this time, just finishing off the refuelling. And that is the only thing they're allowed to do at one time. They can change the wheels and change drivers, but not refuel at the same time. So safety car continues, and in the pits, Diana has Ian Sinton.
Obviously,
stop racing before they spark up the fires. There is Jeremy Metcalfe then, our race leader. So the number 16 car appears somehow not to have gained a lap. Now, I'm not quite sure how they've managed to sort themselves out, but they have. Let's get down to the pits with Diana and see if Luke Hines is any clearer.
Look, it looked like you were in the lead there, but was there a situation with the safety car?
Yeah, I mean, I was in the lead the whole way through. Safety car come out and two front of two flat vipers, and he put his hand up in the air and waved them through. And I was behind them and went through. He had his hand up and was waving through, and then all of a sudden I see a safety car in the middle of the pack holding a red Donetta up. I don't even know, he must have thought it was me. Then let them through. And, you know, he kept putting his hand up and letting people through. So I don't actually know that he knows what car is on the track. So, you know, that's a shame, really, because it shouldn't get to that point.
Yes. So, clearly no clearer there then. Still, luckily for them, there is no penalty applied at the moment to the number 16 car, and it is still our race leader. And with lots of action yet to go, they've still got just about an hour of racing. So, given what we've seen so far, anything could be just around the corner. But just behind is the Ascari. So let's get back to the racing on the track. There is the Jones brothers just going through shot as we again lap Matt Nicol-Jones, the blue Ginetta that is our GT4 leader. And again, Kelvin, only a couple of seconds between first and second.
Yeah, it's tight. We've got Jeremy Metcalfe in that leading Ferrari. And as you said, Martin, just a couple of seconds behind David Jones now in the Ascari car. That's a quick car. And let's see, there they are both in the shot, the Jones car with the headlights ablaze. So Metcalfe needs to drive tidily and decisively through this traffic. There's a lot of sort of battles and stragglers to get his way through, and he needs to do that without losing too much time.
Yeah, because if he does lose any time, David Jones is going to be all over him looking for the lead. Here is our race leader then, Jeremy Metcalfe, and he is the man who's leading the battle for the runner-up spot and also leading the race, and so that's looking pretty much assured for he and Luke Hines. They'll be, well, if they were Germans, they'd be vice champions, but of course runners-up here. Meanwhile, the battle on for third place. Of course, David Jones is in second in the Ascari, but he is losing ground to Jeremy Metcalfe. Just a tenth or two a lap, but it's enough to keep Metcalfe nice and safe. And it's Alan Simonson who's really the fastest man on the track. He's catching Michael Cullen for third place. Of course, a few spins at McLean's.
Possible, yeah, it's possible. You sit very low in these cars, and if you haven't got a tinted visor or a strip on your visor, you can get unsighted by it. But
Nissan back out, so Maxi Jazz has had some repairs made. It doesn't look like it's entirely straight, though, that car. It's really crabbing quite badly. But it should make the flag as the leader is on his last lap. The CR Scuderia boys climbing the fence. Here's the battle for third. Michael Cullen, Alan Simonson. Simonson closing in fast. They had a bit of a titanic scrap at Brands Hatch that Simonson won with some pretty robust moves. And that's David Jones off on the outside on the last lap and crawling very slowly. And it looks, Kelvin, like he's parking that car. So this is now the battle for second.
Yeah, so that's played into these two hands. It did look like he was parking the car. And Simonson got a great momentum out of the old hairpin there, climbing up the hill. But David Jones, I think he's just swapping to the safer inside of the track there, but I'm pretty sure he's parking. So Alan Simonson looking for second place on the last lap of the race. Now Michael Cullen is going to be very defensive. Maxi Jazz thankfully won't play a part in that battle. So out of the chicane is the leader.
Victory then in the final race of the season. Jeremy Metcalfe winning it, and Luke Hines and he become runners-up in the championship for second place. It is going to be Michael Cullen power sliding across the line, is it? It's going to be a drag race with Simonson on the grass. Cullen very robust in his defence. Simonson finishes on the podium, but it could have been a little different if the door hadn't been quite so firmly shut. Finn.
Well, that's it. Another fantastic year of British Jeep.